If it's obvious, it cannot be patented. Patents can only be granted when they have an inventive step.
A what?
My name is Marta. I am team manager in the area online user engagement at the EPO, and this is Head Start. Imagine visiting a restaurant because they claim to serve an inventive new dish. If you are presented with a risotto that just has a little bit more parmesan than usual, you wouldn't call that inventive, right? You may consider that it is an improvement, but for a chef, it's an obvious tweak. The same goes for inventions filed for patent protection. Not only must your invention be novel, that is, not invented by anyone else before, but it must also involve an inventive step. This means being more than just a combination of known features leading to an expected result. It also means that the invention is not obvious to the person skilled in the art, who is someone skilled in the relevant technical field. You need to show a significant step towards solving a technical problem, which is why we call this criterion inventive step. For any business dealing with innovation, inventive step is crucial. If you are willing to pay to get and maintain a patent that gives you the exclusive right to make, sell, or license your product, you want to ensure that this truly unique invention gives you the competitive edge and justifies the cost. Remember that it's a role of the patent system to support technical developments. The inventive step requirement also means that obvious routine technical developments can be freely used by everyone, including you, without infringing on anybody's intellectual property, and thus paving the way to further innovation. Let me give you two examples of inventions that would likely pass the inventive step requirement. An improved surgical tool that reduces the risks of an operation, or a new type of battery with a prolonged lifespan. Some people worry that judging the non-obviousness of invention is difficult. And they are right. This is why at the EPO, applications are examined by not just one, but three examiners working as a team. This also ensures that the objectivity of the assessment. In order to assess inventive step, our examiners use the problem-solution approach. First, they clearly define the problem that the invention aims to solve. For example, that batteries have a relatively short lifespan. Then, they check how other inventors have already tried to solve this problem. And finally, they assess whether the invention is a truly new solution or whether it would have been obvious to the person skilled in the art. So next time you draft a claim for your patent application, try to apply yourself the problem-solution approach to check if it's inventive.